Hello creators, we've recently launched the new VSDC version 9.2. Have you had a chance to try out the new tools yet? Today we're going to dive deeper and show you all the new features. This will help you make the most out of this release. Let's get started. AI segmentation. The new segmentation effect allows you to highlight static or moving objects for precise object removal, color correction within a specific area, and the application of various effects such as censorship and masking. The best part? It's free. To apply the effect, select the object on the timeline and navigate to Video Effects, Special Effects, Segmentation. Then download AI models from our website. For lower performance PCs, we recommend using the Edge SAM or Mobile SAM models. For our example, we will select and import Mobile SAM. Click on Add Region, draw an area including the object you want to select. This automatically creates a black and white mask showing what algorithm has detected. Switch to composite mode to view the cutout results. Then you can add an outline to the object or leave just the contour. Adjustments can be made by modifying the edit region or setting post filtering to true in the properties, which slightly smoothes the edges. Moving on, below in the properties, you can see the region you added earlier. Here you can also add additional regions that may exclude or include new areas for analysis. Expanding the coordinate type property allows you to add motion animation to the region's boundaries, thus covering all necessary frames by adjusting the position of the region frame. If the segmentation isn't perfect, refine it by adding points that can either include or exclude elements. You can also animate their coordinates or link a tracking point to them. Before doing so, create a tracking point and set its movement using motion tracking. VSDC Cloud Service. In the latest update, we've introduced a dedicated platform, VSDC Cloud Service. This platform is designed to store your files and projects, allowing you and other users to access them from anywhere in the world. To learn more about this service, follow the link in the description. On the website, you can find subscription plans, including an almost free option for $1 that provides 15 GB of storage space. It is important to remember the email address you use to purchase the subscription, and then register on VSDC Cloud with that email. After purchasing, go to cloud.videosoftdev.com and complete the registration using the same email as when you bought the subscription. Now your cloud is ready to use, and you can upload files and create folders. Next, let's move to VSDC. In the main menu, you will find the new option to save or open a project with VSDC Cloud. Choose to save your project. Enter the email and password from your registration in the dialog box. Then select the location to save the project. This will store the project and all associated files on the cloud, allowing you to access them from any device. Wedding templates. The next update introduces the first pack in our new line of video templates, wedding video templates, perfect for creating beautiful intros. You can find them in the template window under the wedding folder. To access the complete pack of wedding templates, right-click on any of them and select the Purchase Template option to buy all 20 items. After purchasing, return to the program and enter the activation key sent to your email by right-clicking the template again. This will allow you to use or edit them. For instance, if you click on the text in the preview scene several times, the text editor will open. You can also change the template's color by applying the color correction effect to the gold layer. Video transition templates. In addition to the wedding templates, VSDC 9.2 introduces over 300 transition templates, designed to work with transition areas created by holding the Alt key. These transitions are divided into 13 packs, and you can purchase each pack separately. The purchase and activation process is similar to that of the wedding templates. Let's explore any group. Create transition area by holding the Alt key and then drag your preferred transition into this area. Done. Now you can adjust the duration of the transition. For more detailed information on the transition sets, visit the VSDC store page. Batch export. The next update concerns the Video Convert tool, which now supports projects, not just video files. Open the video converter and drag in the projects you created in VSDC that you need to render. Adjust the profile settings for exporting your projects and click Export. This is very convenient if you need to set up rendering in the background or leave your computer running, right? Subtitle Enhancement. The Subtitle tool has also received improvements. When creating subtitles from scratch, the first timestamp now appears automatically in the editing window, making it easy to edit or copy for new subtitle lines. Additionally, the long-awaited ability to outline subtitles and change their color using keyframes in the parameters text color, contour color, and brush has been added. But that's not all. Subtitles can now be converted to text, allowing you to apply text and video effects to them. Simply right-click on the subtitles and select Convert to Text. New text layers will be created automatically on the timeline. Extended support for frame rate and project resolution. You can now create projects with resolutions up to 8K and frame rates up to 300 frames per second and export videos with these settings. This option is especially useful if your source video has the same specifications. However, be careful. We do not recommend using these settings on videos with lower resolution or frame rates, as it may degrade their quality. Resample effect update. The Resample tool has also been enhanced. You can now mirror the created copies, allowing for seamless images. This effect is very useful for creating backgrounds or filling empty spaces. Additionally, you can select the center for the effect and fine-tune the stretching along the X and Y axis. Cutting and splitting window. Working with the cutting and splitting window has become even more convenient. Starting from this version, you can toggle the display of the storyboard and waveform. These options typically require significant PC resources, so disabling them can reduce the load. Moreover, this window now remembers its position, so it will appear in the same location the next time you open it. Fading Sinusoid template. The new version also includes the Fading Sinusoid template, which allows for creating fading or appearing effects. For example, if you create an object that appears through a zoom effect, the sinusoid can add a bounce effect instead of a linear movement. The template offers many parameters to customize it for various tasks, including a randomizer option to create random curve parameters. Working with the timeline. Lastly, timeline management has been enhanced. A new button, Use Shift to Set Work Area, has been added to the Timeline Options section. With this option, the work area will remain fixed while moving the cursor along the timeline, until you hold down the Shift key. This means you no longer need to reset the work area each time. And that's all for now. We hope you enjoy the new version. More exciting updates are coming soon.